students, I warmly welcome all of you and I hope that you all are quite fine. Over here, guys, we will know about first chapter from your textbook, First Flight, Chapter 1, A Letter to God, written by G.L. Fuentes. As you all know that G.L. Fuentes is a Mexican writer, novelist, and also journalist. This story is also a Mexican story. We have discussed about a summary of this story, A Letter to God, in our previous video. Over here, we will know about line by line explanation of the story, A Letter to God. Guys, actually this story, A Letter to God, is about the great faith of a simpleton, about a fatuous peasant in the God, and who writes a letter to the God asking for some monetary help means economic help. Lencho is the protagonist of this story, as I have depicted here. Lencho is protagonist of the story. He writes a letter to the God asking for monetary help, and the letter was received by postman, and that postman gave that postmaster of the post office. After collecting money from his colleagues, the postmaster sent 70 pesos to the Lencho, protagonist of this story. 70 pesos, I do know that 1 pesos is equal to 100 cents, and pesos is a North American unit, a monetary unit of several Latin American countries, because this story is a Mexican story and the pesos is a monetary unit system of Mexico. So over here we will explain this story line by line. It begins that the house, the only one in the entire valley, sat on the crest of a low hill. There were only one house in whole valley, and having seated on top crest means top of lower hill, one could see even ripe field, ripe corn, river, and ripe corn dotted with flowers, means sporadic or scattered with flowers. That always seems to be a good harvest or a good yield crops. The only thing the earth needed was a downpour or at least a shower. There were only one need for the downpour, means heavy rain, or even for light rain, means there were need of water for that field, for crop of the field. Throughout the morning, Lencho, who knew his field intimately, had done nothing else but see the sky towards the northeast. From morning, Lencho was thinking, he was thinking about water, even for downpour or shower for his field, and had done some nothing. He could not do anything, only he was looking towards sky for the waters, and he intimately, means he closely knew about his field, about agriculture, that when there is need of water or manure or other things, so he was waiting for rain for his crops. Now we are really going to get some water, woman. And having seen towards northeast sky cloudy rain, he guessed, he imagined, and then he told his wife that now we are going to get really some water for their field crops. The woman who was preparing supper replied, yes, God willing. And that woman who was preparing dinner for the family, she told that, yes, of course, God willing, it is blessings of God that we will get some water for our field. The older boys were working in the family, in the field. The older boys of the family working in the field, while the smaller ones were playing near the house, until the woman called to them all. Older boys of the family, of Lencho, he was working in the field, while the smaller ones, they were playing out of the, near the house or out of the house. Their mother, wife of Lencho, called them all, come for dinner, that please come all of you for dinner. And it was during the meal that, it was the time of dinner, time of meal, that just as Lencho had predicted, just few moments, minutes ago, Lencho had predicted, had forecasted that big drops of rain began to fall, and then the big drops of rain began to fall. It was already predicted by Lencho himself. In the northeast, huge mountains of cloud could be seen approaching, and from northeast side, huge mountain of cloud was approaching. Oncoming cloud can be seen there, and the air was fresh and sweet. Cloudy rain, because the rain was about to hail there, and so the weather was very fresh, sweet and pleasing. The man went out for no other reason than to have the pleasure of feeling the rain on his body. And Lencho went out without reason. He had not any other reason to go out, but he went out only to feel the dropping rain, rains falling rain on his own body, to get pleasure, to enjoy, to feel enjoy. He went out to feel the raining raindrops on his body. And when he returned, he explained. And when he returned, when he came back, he exclaimed with happiness. He told that these are not raindrops falling. These are not only raindrops which are falling from the sky, but they are new coins. He had compared raindrops from his cones. Crops, that they are new coins. The big drops are 10 cent pieces. Those which are big drops are falling, they are nearly 10 cent pieces, and the little ones are 5. Means he had compared big drop and small drops with his crops. With a satisfied expression, he regarded the field of ripe corn with its flower, and he was fully satisfied with this falling rain, because his crops was nearly about to be ready. Floods draped in a curtain of rain. After he observed that whole field had covered with the raindrops, rain, falling rain, but suddenly a strong wind began to blow. With hail, hailstones also, very large hailstones began to fall after the big drops of rain. these truly did resemble new silver coins, and it was similar to new silver coins. The voyage, only for the voyage, exposing themselves to the rain, ran out to collect the frozen pearls. Exposing himself, voyage went out to collect, to receive the frozen pearls hailed from outside house. It is really getting bad now, exclaimed with the man, and then again Lencho exclaimed with sorrow, having seen the hailstorm and big storm, that I hope it is really getting bad now. It is being really bad now. Whatsoever his hope was before, his aspirations, his hope disappeared, vanished away. And so he is telling that this is really getting bad now. I hope it passes quickly. And that former peasant is hoping that it will pass quickly. Sooner, it did not pass quickly. For an hour, the hail rained on the house. Hail rained on the house nearly 1 hour. And the garden and the hillside, the cornfield and the whole valley, the field was white as if it was appearing like a salt. This whole area was covered with hailstone, and there not a leaf remained on the trees, and there were no single leaf remained on the tree. Leaves cracked down, dropped from the branches of the tree, and the corn was totally destroyed. Whole crops was completely ruined, destroyed. The flowers were gone from the plant. There were no flowers on the plants. Lencho's soul was filled with sadness, and that Lencho's soul, he was happy before a few moments. He endured in melancholia, sadness, sorrow. When the storm had passed, he stood in the middle of the field. Having stood in the middle of the field, he said to his sons that a plague of locust would have left more than this. Means he was telling that even his insects can leave more than this. But this hailstones and strong wind has not left anything else here. The hail has left nothing. This year we will have no corn. Now we have no more corn for our livelihood. And that night was a sorrowful, sad, full of sadness, full of melancholy one for all of them, for a whole member of the family, all member of the family, all our work for nothing. We have done everything for good yield, good harvest, but now we have nothing. And there is no one who can help. There is no one, because entire valley there were only one house. So there is no one to help us. Who will help us? We will all go hungry this year. And the family, Lencho Patagnis, was hoping, thinking that we all go hungry, will remain hungry this year. Thank you, all of you. I hope that you would like explanation of this chapter. For further explanation, see you again in next video. Have a pleasing day, all of you. Thank you.